in the life they're living, you can't half step. It starts with the young ones doing crimes for fun. And if you ain't down, you'll get played out, son. So let's get a car you know I fly with. Get a dent, roll a screwdriver, and be off quick with the dope ride, yeah, and a rowdy crew. We could bag us a fence and an Audi too. Even
oh yeah. Round and round, round we go. I get around. Still clown when the underground, when we come around. Stronger than ever. Back to get wrecked. All respect to those who break their neck to keep their hopes in check. Cause though they sweat a brother majorly. And I don't know why your girl keeps paging me. She tell me that she needs me. Cries when she leaves me. And every time she sees me, she squeeze me. Lady, take it easy. Hate to sound sleazy, but tease me. I don't want it if it's that easy. Hey yo, bust it. Baby, got a problem saying bye-bye. Just another ass of a fly guy.
All right. Welcome back to The Situation. Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is DSP News, the Unreliable Ones. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the newsroom and welcome to the Gautopia News Network, your unreliable source for DSP News. This is the Snort Report brought to you by Snortbucks Coffee Company, the best beverage company, as well as Hard Snorts Gin and Tonic, that toxic flavor that'll never waver. Hopefully you guys are all doing well. Okay, so, where are we at on the menu today? Looks like we'll be talking about DSP Reacts yet again. Apparently DSP is taking this as some type of ongoing learning lesson. He's trying to re-educate himself, let's say that, as it pertains to the internet in general. Let's see if we can try to add anything to that. So, as you guys all know, welcome to my TED Talk. This reaction channel thing is going to fail, obviously. As you have seen up to this particular point, he is devoting more and more time to it and emphasis. Because of that, the DSP Gaming, I am guessing, though I do not know exactly what's going on at the moment that I'm currently recording, is starting to suffer. I would assume that the members' goal on the main channel is probably weighing. I would assume just content over there in general is suffering, and that's because DSP cannot diversify. He can't do more things. He can't do a bunch of things at once. Especially if he has experienced early success at something, he'll literally drop everything else he's doing to pursue that, which is a character trait, a character flaw in a lot of ways, to be honest with you. Most people want overall success. Well, if you're a born loser, you'll chase after whatever you can get your hands on, and you'll do whatever you can to hold it. Which is unfortunate because it gives people a reason to attack you. And it gives them something direct that they can attack you on. And you really can't do much, to be honest. You're not going to want to try to rock the boat. And with DSP, who has a a withering viewer base and fan base, at least his casual base is gone, I should say. He's kind of been reduced to the base of what his viewership is. It's very hard to get them to contribute on multiple fronts, right? I've spoken about this in a previous video. I'm not sure if it's out yet, but I had said that all he's doing is cutting his viewer base in half or his fan base in half or whatever, and they're not going to be able to contribute on all sides. So something's going to have to falter. Something's going to have to fail. Something's going to have to fall by the wayside while essentially the new thing that he's trying to promote is really a whole lot like the old thing. So if we were struggling on DSP Gaming before DSP Reacts, DSP Reacts will get what DSP Gaming had and DSP Gaming will falter. Can't have both. He really can't. He spent a whole lot of time shitting on detractors, shitting on the restreamers, and saying, hey, if you don't want to deal with what I'm dealing with over here or what I'm providing you over here or whatever the case may be, then leave. Fuck you. And so they did. And as time has gone on, you've seen what the results of that is. You are seeing his opposition to detractors, trolls, haters, and critics who have flourished, for the most part, over a number of years as it pertains to streaming and or restreaming, where DSP has faltered. And now the platforms that were out there where were willing to baby him or had or their infrastructure had something in place to allow him the benefit without him investing very much, except for just showing up. He no longer can make money on that platform. Let me reiterate, DSP is not banned from Twitch. He is demonetized off Twitch. He can't make any money over there unless it's directly through tips, which is directly through PayPal. That's it. he can't make no money on Twitch. And I am of the thought that if he could go back and even just get affiliate, if he really qualified for that, he would have done it by now. Don't listen to any of his bullshit about how it's a bad business and it doesn't respect its content creators. Stop. Please stop. You know that those words are just as hollow as any other threat or promise he's ever made. At the end of the day, a phantom snort is a phantom snort. If he could go back, he would go back. Let's just call a spade a spade. Same thing with Wings. If Wings was able to hit the moment, actually, that Wings qualifies for affiliate or partner again and can get monetized on Twitch, he's going right back. Because, yet again, Wings isn't banned from Twitch either. He just can't. He was demonetized off Twitch. So these are just some things that you need to we can take into consideration moving forward as it pertains to just the reaction content in general. It's terrible. He has nothing that he can really add to it. He tries to over-explain stuff that he really doesn't understand, or he doesn't really know what he's talking about. He, as far as I see it, the more reaction content he does, the more disconnected from the world around him is what he's going to show. Let's reword that. The more reaction content he does, the lack of awareness or the lack of connection to our current day and age is going to show. You're going to really, he's going to eventually prove that he's the hermit that we all joke about. This is what happens, ladies and gentlemen, when you live in your own bubble for too long because you're too scared to face what people say or think about you. And he's not strong enough to try to better himself, so instead he hides. And because of that is the reason why he's behind on everything. You can be successful doing reactionary content. It requires a lot from you as a person. You know what I'm saying? You have to show some characteristics about your personality that really shines through. You know what I'm saying? You can't expect the content to carry you. It's a little bit of a give and take, to be honest with you. You know, people, the way you react to anything is people being invested in what you're doing and how you, you know what I'm saying, and who you are as a person. Well, if you're an empty shell, if you're a piece of garbage, and you're an uninteresting or you lack any real insight, or if you're just an unentertaining piece of garbage, then that's just what it's going to show. That's what's going to be proven. And more importantly than that, as it pertains to reactionary content, stay in your lane. Don't try to run around and chase everything that's popular. Stick to what you know or what you allegedly know. Which for DSP, it would be as I said before, it would be wrestling, reacting to stuff as it pertains to the FGC, Street Fighter probably in particular. Just so you can see the lack of insight he has on that, which I'm really hoping he bites on that, but we'll see. And really, he just likes seeing people get hurt or injured. That's it. You know what I'm saying? To be honest with you, maybe he'll throw some cute cat bullshit or cute animal stuff in there too. But other than that, you're not going to find too much out of it. And as it pertains to The Last of Us show he's been reacting to, I'm sure you guys have seen the train wreck that is. But anyway, we'll let time tell. You know what I'm saying? Maybe I'm being too judgmental. You know what I'm saying? What right do I have? Plenty, but whatever. So let's go ahead and get into the situation itself. The situation itself. Hopefully you guys, yet again, are all doing well. Try to have some fun with this and make of it what you will. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the situation at hand. I don't really know what to tell you. I don't smell no motherfucking bacon cooking, though. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into it. I will see you guys in just a second. But tease me, I don't want it if it's that easy. Hey yo, bust it. Baby, got a problem saying bye-bye. Just another hazard of a fly guy. Your ass wide don't matter. My pockets got fatter. Now everybody's looking for the ladder. And ain't no need in being greedy. If you wanna see me, try to keep a number, baby, when you need me. And I'll be there in a jiffy. Don't be picky, just be happy with the
till you learn. You can't time it down, baby doll. Check it out. I get around.
Of gameplay today, unlike yesterday, where half the day was React content over on DSP React. And
okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's a minor inconvenience. Not sure what happened there. We just had something happen. But we're back at it now. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're here with a super cut by our homie Diggs. Let's see here. What do we call this? Darkside Phil catches up with the times with reaction content. This is from February 18th of 2023. The link to the source, which will more than likely be either DSP Gaming itself or Raw DSP, will be linked down in the description. And Dig's Supercut may show up in a link down there. If not, it might eventually. Whatever the case may be. We will see. Here we go.
Of gameplay today, unlike yesterday, where half the day was React content over on DSP React. And a portion of today's pre-stream podcast, what I would like to do here is basically talk about what we're learning about React content now that I'm doing it on a regular basis. You know, yesterday I did episode 1 of DSP versus the Internet. This is the weekly show where I'm going to be reacting to clips from all over YouTube as submitted by the members. And, you know, the more the members submit, the better. But it's the first episode of the show. It was the first time that we had an opportunity to really do something interactive like this. And we're learning. We're learning, gee, what kind of clips work, what don't. And what I'd like to do today on the show is talk a little bit about that. Talk just a little bit about what we're learning slowly. Also, I want to talk a little bit about my ideas for the channel, because already I've started a second thing that wasn't originally planned, and people seem to like it. It's a Last of Us TV series review series of videos. So we'll talk about that. We got some news to talk about today, gaming news in particular, two or three stories. Now, two of the stories are relatively quick. One of them could be a much bigger discussion. I don't know if you guys have heard about the whole Section 230, court case going on in the United States government that's going to actually be heard by the Supreme Court on Tuesday. It's a big picture kind of a topic. It may not even be something that can be easily discussed in one little portion or sitting. So I don't know if we're going to talk about that today or not. We basically have until like Tuesday to talk about it on one of these shows, because nothing's going to happen between now and Tuesday. But it's a big picture kind of a topic that could affect the internet as a whole or could affect absolutely nothing. So I think we should eventually talk about it, okay? So, we got some good stuff to talk about today, and you know, as usual...
The Section 230 thing will more likely be a whole separate video, but it's essentially DSP wanting regulations to come through and play Captain Save-A-Ho and get rid of his namesayers, which he's going to find out very quickly if that ends up being a thing, that the moment his detractors, trolls, haters, and critics get pushed off the board, so will he. So he's going to learn very quickly that, you know, he's going to find out his place in the world. Very, very quickly if something like that passes. It's kind of stupid to go ahead and push your namesayers off the internet because of various reasons, especially if it can be proven what they're saying is true. So, you know. And then I'm sure there's going to be some talk about, oh, if I was rich, I'd be able to do this, I'd be able to do that. You're going to bleed your wealth in court over some shit that people said about you that they can prove? I mean, that sounds kind of retarded. You know what I'm saying? Like, it'd be different if it was actual slander or defamation, which you would have to be able to prove that at the time that those people knew what was being said about you was a lie. And it's very easy to get around that. But anyway, whatever.
We have time for some Q&A. We'll do that as well. Before we get started, he's going to really go for this bottle cap. Jasper, you cannot have my bottle cap. I'm sorry. You can't have it. It's not yours. Okay. Before we get to any of that, all right, one thing I just want to talk about and get it out of the way so I don't have to talk about it again. Now, what about DSP Reacts, my React channel?
Yeah, I wish you did get that out of the way so we wouldn't have to hear about it anymore. That's going to be a slow death. This reaction channel thing is going to be a slow death, and he's going to be very, very salty. A very, very salty pig that if it fails. Because, as I said in a previous broadcast, he's going to put all of the blame on the audience in general. That's why it's all front-loaded. You know what I mean? That's the reason why, hey, you have to become a member, and then you get voting rights, and so on and so forth. So if you want to keep it going, not only do you have to give me money, right? You have to put your money down to get yourself a membership, but hey, you might want to put some gifted memberships out there too. You know what I'm saying? Just to get what you want, because let's be honest, there's not enough people over there to get all those gifted memberships anyway. Which just funnels more money into his pocket for little to nothing. And then sooner than later, just like he did with the Player's Choice marathons and whatever, he's going to start skewing stuff. He's going to start being like, oh, well, you know, I don't know how many people here were just being trolls or whatever the case may be, and you guys want me to react to this? Well, we're not going to react to that now because I don't know if the voting is legit. And thank you, dummies, for the money, but I'm going to go ahead and we're going to go with this now. And you're going to see him try to swerve the voting so he can react to content that he knows or that he believes that he can get money off of, he can get ad revenue off of, I should say. Because remember, he's telling you right now, oh, I don't care about ad revenue. Granted, though, he's a hypocrite and a liar. So he says he doesn't care about ad revenue, but he also keeps telling you, oh, well, I can't react to that because that might block the stream. Or I can't react to that because maybe no one will be able to see it if it's blocked or if it's claimed. And he doesn't really go into detail on, oh, well, what happens if a video gets claimed? If a video, like, I can tell you, because we use copyrighted music all the time. If the video gets claimed, it just means that it can't be monetized. It doesn't hurt me, because the channel's not monetized either which way. But if I was, I wouldn't be able to gain monetization off of it. Whoever the copyright owners are would essentially have rights to it. DSP don't want that. DSP doesn't want to share the profits with anybody. So he wants his front-end money, meaning the memberships. He wants you guys to come to the event and tip, and he wants his ad revenue. He's not giving any of that up. And sooner or later, you're going to see how it all swerves around like that. And theoretically, that's triple dipping, but actually we're talking about quad dipping, actually, because there's Patreon. Oh, well, if there's something that you want me to react to that's over 30 minutes or at 30 minutes or whatever the case may be, go ahead and just pay $50 to get a private video on Patreon. Just do that. So, this scheme will work for a little while, but I think I said, 4 to 6 months? And then you'll see what's what? I mean, stuff is already tapering off over there now. And the reason why that is because it's a dead channel. He has to really put in a lot of work for a while until, you know, it really starts to catch on and build. Whereas if he got a new channel, yeah, it's still going to be a lot of work and whatever, but whoever it is that's making all those sock accounts over there are going to make sure it happens. Whoever it is going to sit there and have shit playing on repeat to get the hours requested or required to, you know, make monetization. I'm not saying it's going to be any easier, but it certainly would be less, it wouldn't be nearly as difficult as what he's going through right now. At the end of the day, he's put himself at a deficit, which is the only thing Phil Brunel is known for doing. And it's going to demotivate him. But then again, he's supposed to be the ultimate underdog, right? So there's not supposed to be any quit in him, right? So, you know, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he'll stick with it for a year or two and go after that, well, like I said, him going after that second play button for that channel. Because I think that's what he's gunning for, too. I honestly think he wants that. I honestly think he believes he deserves it. But we'll see.
There's content pretty much every day. Today, we've already released DSP versus the Internet, Episode 1, Part 3. That came out at 10 a.m. Okay? Give it a look. It's about 20, 25 minutes. Then, later today at noon, that's right, while I'm doing this podcast, the next part of my DSP reviews, The Last of Us TV series, Episode 2 and 3, that review will actually go live on DSP Reacts at noon today. So that's the one a lot of people are waiting on because I guess episodes 2 and 3 were very highly, how can I say, like everyone reviewed episode 2 one way, and then there was a ton, an absolute ton of disagreement when it came to episode 3. People seem to be of a huge dichotomy when it came to this episode. Some people love episode 3, some people hate it, and everyone seems to have a different reason. I'm sure you're interested in my take. Well, you're getting it today over on DSP React, so give it a look, okay? Now, What I'm going to do is
and see,
today,
interestingly but... enough, for a reaction channel, his opinion's already tainted because he's already going off of what other people have already said. I'm just throwing that out there. So that's a problem. That's a bit of an issue. You know what I mean? Like, how much of this is actually authentic? Same thing with his game reviews in a lot of ways. How much of that did he actually formulate on his own, or how much of it did he just rip off Twitter and then just try to put a spin to it? Just something to think about. just something to think about. You know what I mean? So take all of that with a grain of salt too. Salt.
Next several days, a new part of DSP versus the Internet will release at 10 a.m. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, each day, a new part of DSP versus the Internet at 10 a.m. over there. As for the rest of my Last of Us review series, well, I didn't see episodes 4 and 5 yet. I'm actually going to watch them tonight. So I will film my review for that tomorrow and release it late tomorrow night. Okay? So basically tomorrow, Sunday, there'll be DSP versus the Internet at 10 a.m.
You know what?
And my review.
I'm going to be an asshole about this because why not? DSP has told his audience for years that he couldn't do these type of things because he didn't have time, right? He works 6 days a week, 12... sorry. try to be serious about this. He works 6 days a week, 12-hour days, right? Because, you know, he's in the office like an hour or two before the stream starts, and then he's in the office... Then he stays in the office for like 2 or 3 hours after the last stream at night ends. So, you know... So 12 hours, right? 14 hours, whatever the case may be. But he told people for years that he could never do this. There wasn't enough time to do it. He didn't really see the value in it. He didn't believe that anybody else would see the value in it. And really, it just came down to time constraints. He had a life. He has a wife. He has a declaw cat. He has a lot going on in his personal life that he needs to do, that he needs to keep together. He needs work life balance. So what changed? You know, I think it's a fair question. What changed that now we all of a sudden have all this time to do all this, that we can make all these sacrifices and whatnot? I mean, Jesus Christ, since Slayer has been paying $50 on Patreon to do his own personal React videos, his only snorts, if you will, DSP used to sit there and try to make excuses on how he didn't have time to even record those. But now we're trying to devote all of this time to a whole separate channel? At night, when he's supposed to be relaxing after a hard day's work, he's sitting here watching all this additional content and whatnot to produce more reaction content? Interestingly enough, too, I almost missed this. He says that there was a lot of... there's a lot of discussion around episodes 2 and 3 of Last of Us, right? Yet, this idiot has his comment section so regulated, so heavily regulated, that none of that discussion is happening where it needs to happen, which is on his channel. That's what he should want. He should want the engagement over there. But since everything has to be filtered through before it can actually go live, the conversation is dead before it can ever even start. So even with an opportunity like this for the very few dents over there to really have some conversation about this subject and even have their agreements or disagreements of what DSP has to say as it pertains to his reaction to it, which is already tainted, as I already said, that conversation can't even happen. It can't even happen. It'll never really exist the way he needs it to, because our ego is so goddamn fragile that he's scared that a few trolls are going to go over there and shit it up. Even though that right there might actually push the conversation even further. But we can't think like that, right? You know, that right there is someone who's forward thinking. That's someone who can see past his bullshit for the greater good of the content, which in turn, allegedly, is supposed to help contribute to his household, to help him support his wife and his cat. Because remember, Catherine's in retail. Retail's taking a hit right now. She's not able to get the hours that she needs, or that they need, I should say. So all of that financial responsibility is on him, right? Right? Right. But yeah, we're not going to do what we need to do to help us, to help himself. become a better provider for the people that he supposedly loves and cares for. Maybe I'm overthinking this. I could be. I could be.
The Last of Us episodes 4 and 5 at 10 p.m. Pacific time. You see? Same thing on Monday, because what I'm going to do Sunday night is watch the new episode of The Last of Us as it releases on HBO Max, which is episode 6, and then I'm going to do a review of it on Monday. So basically Monday morning, again, more DSP versus the internet, and then late that night after I finish my gameplay streams, I'll film my episode and release DSP reviews episode 6 of The Last of Us, okay? So you're getting tons of content. You're going to get reviews, you're going to get React content all over there on DSP Reacts. If you haven't checked out the channel yet, what are you waiting for? It's not even a week old, and already we've gotten something like 2,000 subscribers added to the channel just since I announced it last week. The videos are getting thousands of views, which is great. I really appreciate that. People seem to really be liking the content. So please check it out. It's youtube.com/@DSPReacts. And of course, I'm going to plug and say, please become a member over there. Why? Well, there's two main reasons why I would love for you to become a member on DSP React.
One more thing before he gets into his reactions to his membership shilling. We have all the time to do all this, yeah? We have all the time to do all this, but we can't edit anything. I want you to think about that. You know what I'm saying? We already talked about the aspects of, you know, him not having any time to do any of this, you know, like a year ago, because he needed to spend time with his family, right? He didn't want to overwork himself after those long 12 to 14 hour days or whatever, whatever. But he's finding all the time and opportunity to do what he's doing now, right? But we couldn't edit a video worth a lick. That wasn't possible. He stayed away from editing like it was Ebola or some shit. It just couldn't happen. It never could happen. His wife could be downstairs crying that because he might be overworking himself if that was the case. You could literally bring that woman to tears if he even considered trying to do more work than what he's normally used to. But now look at him. Trying to pull off 18-hour days like a regular person, I guess, or what his interpretation of a regular person is. It really makes you question some shit, because I would assume the money at this particular point isn't that high. I wouldn't think so. I mean, he just launched the reaction channel on what? February 12th? I mean, shit. At the time that I'm recording this, I was only like 6 or 7 days ago. It wasn't that long ago. Something about.
I don't make any ad revenue on that channel. All those videos when I'm reacting, they all get claimed. The only videos I'm making money on is the reviews. The reviews, I'm just talking. And because of that, those aren't going to get claimed, and I can actually make some ad revenue on them. It's funny because people are like, why don't you add in footage of the show into your reviews? Because then it would get claimed. The moment I add in footage from
that's
the show,
true.
That's it.
Or that's not completely true. Excuse me. There's some reaction channels that I enjoy watching that actually have clips of it. They're not going to play the whole episode, obviously. But they'll have clips that coordinate to what segments that they're recording on. Or that they're reviewing, I should say, usually playing off in the background somewhere. And like I said, as long as you can make it transformative, you're going to have to jump through a few hoops to make stuff happen, but you can make things happen. He's just too lazy to do that, which goes back to what we just spoke about a few minutes ago about editing. So to sit there and blatantly lie to these people and say, I can't go the extra mile and do such and such, such and such, because that stuff would get claimed, right? Even though he's already admitting that most of the stuff is getting claimed anyway, which in truth shouldn't matter because he's going to make the bulk of his money off memberships anyway. And if he wasn't such a cuck, he could go ahead and really open the comment section up so he can get his super thanks off that too, which probably would help with ad revenue anyway, because he's not going to get 10,000 or 15,000 views per video anyway. So there are alternatives for him to put out a better quality product. You know what I mean? There are not safeguards, but there are ways of compensating to make things happen. But he doesn't want to do it. He just wants to do what he's done for the last 15 years or whatever, chasing ad revenue. And look at where chasing ad revenue has gotten him. If you really think about it. Think about all the times I spoke about some of the opportunities or alleged opportunities that he said he had at one time or another. He tossed all that to the side for ad revenue. Now look at him, begging on the internet like a bitch and whatnot, begging other larger content creators to give him an interview, to give him a shot to tell his story. Like, anybody wants to put that type of failure on their channel, you know what I'm saying, unironically. You know, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but whatever.
I lose all profits on those videos. So, no, I'm not going to do that. I'd like to actually make some money on my work. That would be pretty nice to get paid for work, no?
Oh, so what? So, yeah. What are memberships? Just ask. I mean, I'm going off what he said. He said it'd be nice if he made some money off of his work. So ad revenue. I mean, sorry. So the memberships. What's that? Chopped liver. What is that? Deli lunch meat. What is it? Explain to me what that is. I'm just asking. Here, let's bring it back. Maybe there's something that I missed.
Footage of the show into your reviews, because then it would get claimed. The moment I add in footage from the show, that's it. I lose all profits on those videos. So, no, I'm not going to do that. I'd like to actually make some money on my work. That would be pretty nice to get paid for work, no? So, yeah, since all that reacts...
I mean, now that you brought that up, Phil, you know, how it would be nice to get paid for your work, the guy who does your thumbnails, what about him? What about the people who work on your shorts? What about them? You know what I mean? Anybody else who adds, who sends you free artwork and all that stuff, you ever thought about trying to compensate them? Just saying. You know, it's funny how, you know, Ree needs to be paid and compensated, right? But not really anybody else. It makes you wonder, did he even offer any of those people anything? Just saying, if you're going to put yourself above everybody else, one would think maybe you have some morals, or maybe you actually have some values, maybe you have a code. Treat others as you would want to be treated yourself, maybe, possibly. Even a shout out? Oh, that's right, we don't do that. Because supposedly if we shouted those people out, they might get harassed. Even though, in certain circles within the detractor community, there have been people who said, I wouldn't mind reaching out to whoever did this particular piece of work, and I'd be willing to compensate them. And they said that publicly.
Fully claim, all right? Please consider becoming a member. Now also, if you become a member over there, you become part of the interactive process. You are the people, the members that is, who nominate the videos for my weekly react show, DSP versus the Internet. You're also the ones who are going to be choosing my large-scale projects. For example, it was the channel members who over this week voted on the Pro Jared documentary by June the King, and that's actually a big react topic that we're going to be doing next weekend. And you might say, well, when are we doing that, Phil? I can answer you that. Because yesterday morning, we posted up a poll on the community tab of DSP Reacts to determine the date that I'd be doing that big react event. Excuse me. Ugh. Frog in my throat and I went right down my windpipe. Yuck. So based on that poll, I can now tell you. Hold on a second. I can now tell you when we're doing it. And we're going to find it out right now because I'm going to go to the community tab. That was much better. I cleared it. All right. So based on that poll, we will be doing DSP Reacts to Lies, Deception, and Pro Jared, the story of Pro Jared by June the King on Saturday, February 25th. It will be a day-long event. What we will do is I will do the Level 1 podcast here on DSP Gaming, then we'll switch over to DSP Reacts, and me reacting to that documentary will likely take 3, 4, or more hours. So we'll do it over the course of the day. I'll also order some food, so we'll have some chill food and everything during the stream, and if we happen to end a little early, we'll probably end that stream with a Q&A session. So essentially, it's a marathon-style session next Saturday, one week from today, to do the Pro Jared React event. Okay? So there you go. Members chose the React event. Members are nominating the videos for the shows on DSP React. Members get a ton of power over there. You know, how many times over the years do people say, man, you know, I've become a member of DSP Gaming, but I just don't feel there's enough benefits. You don't give us enough power or enough for it. I'm giving you a tremendous amount of stuff on DSP Reacts. A tremendous amount of features and power over there. All right? So again, please become a member over there if you're not. That would really help out, okay?
But sadly, not enough power or respect to have him mute the mic when he clears his throat, though, right? But a lot of power, you know what I'm saying? A lot of respect. Yeah. I don't know. There must be some appeal to being a dent. There's so many over there, but I'll be damned if I know what it is.
Okay. Now, what I'd like to do, all right, what I would like to do, and by the way, I already see trolls, and I'm just going to get rid of them now because I'm not putting up with the nonsense. If when I see, I'm just going to eliminate the nonsense. And now I have to put up, here's another one, see? Not putting up with the baloney. Whenever I see the baloney, I slap it like this here, ready? Just slap the baloney right away. I don't like, slap the baloney. Shh, get that Oscar Mayer out of my face. I don't like big flagellating baloney. Away with you. Okay. So, let's talk a little bit about what we learned from yesterday. Yesterday, I live streamed DSP versus the Internet, episode 1. It was the first official episode of the series where the members...
You know, interestingly enough that you brought that up, Phil. Ralph is being accused of being into all kinds of freaky stuff and whatnot. I don't know if it's true. I don't know if it's true or not, but from what I read, it's kind of funny. So, you sure you're talking about... You sure, you know... A piece of bologna is being flapped in your face or something else. I'm just saying, maybe Catherine's trying to spice up your love life and whatever, and maybe she's trying to get you to do things. I don't know. I don't know. But you've always come across as a very, trying to be nice about this here. Weird. You've come across as a very weird person over the years. So, you know, is that you referencing something that's gone on in the bedroom over recent months or weeks or whatever the case may be? I'm just putting it out there, man. I'm not there to judge you on whatever it is that you do behind your bedroom doors. Excuse me. But I'm just saying.
Videos over the course of the week, and we reacted to them. Well, I reacted to them, and you reacted to my reactions, correct? So here's what we learned, because it was quite interesting. Because people had nominated all kinds of videos. There was documentary style videos, there were compilations of fails, there were meme compilations, there were funny animal videos, cute animal videos, I would say more scientific videos, comparison videos of old versus new games, man, that was a good, oh, cooking videos, there was actually a cooking video in there, a good variety of stuff, okay, even other YouTubers and reacting to other YouTubers as well, right? So, basically, after this first show, here's kind of what we learned, all right? Not everything's going to work, and that's okay. Every week when I do DSP versus the Internet, you're going to have hits and misses. And I think that it's going to take a while for us to try to nail it down and say, this is what's fun to react to, and this isn't. And I think...
See, he's already boxing himself in. First off, Phil, I have to admit this because I'm a piece of shit and I have no reason to hide it. I'm going to judge the fuck out of you, whatever it is you're doing in your bedroom, if anybody makes that shit public. So let me go ahead and be clear on that. I'm sorry, but I'm not sorry. That's the first thing. Secondly, excuse me, you're going to try to box yourself in. That's clearly what he's talking about here. He wants everybody to give him the same type of content over and over and over again for that weekly show or whatever it is that he's calling it. And he wants that to be the status quo. Instead of having the variety, which is the spice of life, and instead of going with the variety that he just had, he wants to go, yet again, with the surefire bet. What he knows he can get ad revenue on and that he's not going to get hit. Speaking of that, is he getting permission to react to these other content creators' content? Just saying. Because if we can run around to Frederick, to June the King, and to... what's that guy's name? Damn, I can't think of what his name now. The one that does the spooky type content. I can't think of what his name is. I can't remember his old name, but not the new one. It'll come back to me. Maybe, maybe not. If not, someone in the comment section will pick up where I'm dropping. I very much appreciate when people do that, by the way. Is he, did he ran around to get permission from them to react to their content? Is he doing it to some of these other people? Is he, in his own words, showing them that type of respect by doing so? Anywho, just thought I'd put it out there. But, yeah, he's going to try to box himself in. And the content's already starting to go stale. He's going to make it stagnant in a few months doing it like that. He really is. And then once he burns out, let's say he picks one or two types of things he wants to react to. I'm just going to throw some stuff out there. Let's say, I don't know, animals attack and something as it pertains to science. You know, something that he can barely wrap his gen-fueled brain around. He'll do that for a little while until people start picking him apart. And obviously no one in public will see that. He'll just see that in his own little personal queue. Once that happens, once someone ends up, you know, hits a little too close to home, he'll go ahead and give up on that and try to jump to something else. And he'll burn that out. Someone will call him on that, and then he'll bounce to something else. And sooner or later, either the audience will lose interest or he will lose interest. He should just keep going with the status quo as it's going. And just encourage, I'm trying to be nice here, just try to encourage people to tip, give super chats, or super thanks, I should say, and just try to gift memberships. He might as well go with that. Because the ad revenue he's fighting for probably isn't worth a damn anyway. If he's not breaking 5,000 or more, not even say 5,000 would make a difference, really, but if he isn't breaking 5,000 or more per video anyway, then who gives a shit? I mean, true, and that's me lowballing it. Realistically, if he's not pulling, I don't know, let's pick a nice healthy number. If he's not doing 20,000 a video, then who really gives a shit? Just to be honest. And he's definitely not going to touch that. It'll be a year or two before that happens. You know what I mean? And let's say he puts out 10 videos a month. Let's just say he would need 4 of those videos to go viral. You know what I'm saying? And then viral isn't just a couple 100,000 views. Like, he really needs that shit to pop off to the point where other people want to react to what his reaction is. He's not going to do that. So he really has to, he should be really trying to pivot into the very nonsense that he's been presenting us with for the last couple years anyway. His whole business is based off crowdfunding. It's based off a few people contributing, well, a lot of people contributing a little bit. That's what he should be trying to make the focus. This is an older channel. I'm repurposing it. It's going to take probably a good amount of time to get it pushed back into the YouTube algorithm the way that I'm presenting it. So your crowdfunding, as on DSP Gaming, I'm sorry, is pivotal and whatnot, and is pertinent over here with DSP Reacts. So what I request from you guys over there, I'm definitely going to need it here. It's going to take 10 times as much work to get this to where I think it could be if everybody kind of throws in a little bit and does their part. That should be the actual pitch. That should be the proposition that should be presented. Instead, he's sitting here trying to tell them ad revenue doesn't mean anything, but ad revenue means something. Oh, I don't really care about that, but I want to get paid for a full day's work, right? You've got all this, we're contradicting ourselves multiple times for this little bit of nothing. And he still can't see the big picture. The same tactics that he's used on DSP Gaming, which has led to its failure, is the same thing we're doing over here. It's ironic, to say the very least. But it's fitting, too. Failure breeds failure.
Surprises when you think something might not work, and it will. And sometimes you're going to have a time when, this is for sure, it's a shoe and it's going to be funny, and then it's not. Okay? And that's okay. That's perfectly fine. All right, first thing we found out, I can't react to music videos live. I just can't. Now, it's funny because you might say, but Phil, isn't there a patron of yours who's been funding these private patron reacts for like 6 to 8 months that are K-pop videos? Yes. However, when I do those videos, they're on demand. And then I upload the on-demand video, and if there's going to be a copyright claim or something against it, it hits it. And usually there's no problem. Usually what will happen is I just lose the ad revenue on it, but there is no ad revenue. I don't monetize the patron videos. It doesn't even matter. So it's not a big deal. There has been one or two times when, yes, someone actually outright blocked the video on YouTube. And in that case, that sucked. I either had to refilm it or I had to edit out the part that got it blocked, which could take days. Okay? So, usually, when it comes to K-pop style or any kind of music video, it's not a big deal if you do it on demand. However, we were live streaming yesterday, and that same person all right, decided that they were going to do a K-pop video for the live stream. And we watched it, which was all well and good. Honestly, I don't think the video was that good. I think that I've seen many better ones. It was not one of my favorites. But I do the react, and then guess what happens? All of a sudden, I get a giant alert on my screen while I'm streaming in my dashboard. You have been detected as streaming copyrighted content, and your stream may be taken down any moment. Like, it actually said that. And I was staring at it, and I was like, that's weird. So I've only seen that once before. The one time I saw that before was a year ago when I was streaming WWE 2K22 here on DSP Gaming, and we were playing through the showcase mode. And what the showcase mode does is it was seamlessly going between actual footage of real wrestling matches and then the game. And because it had the footage of the real wrestling match in there, I guess that's considered copyrighted content. It shut down my stream. My stream actually stopped. YouTube turned it off. Okay? And that sucked.
Does anybody actually remember that? And the reason why I say that, because wasn't that... I think I was watching a restreamer, actually. I can't think of who. But I think I was watching a restreamer when they were doing that. I think it was like a Halloween Havoc match, I think. It might have been Rey Mysterio versus... I don't know if it was Psychosis or La Parca. I can't remember now, but I think it was... I'm not even sure. But I'm pretty confident it was like a Halloween Havoc match or some shit. And I remember him bitching and complaining about how it got claimed, how the video got claimed on YouTube, but I don't remember him complaining about the stream. If someone can verify that, just for posterity's sake, you know what I'm saying? If not, I can definitely ask someone to, on my end over here, to actually look and see if they can find that. But I don't remember the stream going down, though. It might have, but I don't remember that.
Shut down. Now I gotta start, make a whole new stream, start over. So I can't do that. I can't take that risk that I'm streaming on DSP Reacts and the stream's gonna get shut down. So it seems moving forward, we just can't do K-pop stuff on a live stream. We could definitely do, I could do it on demand for private videos for patrons, but I just can't do it as part of the live stream. All right.
And to be honest with you, this goes back to what I've said previously. That right there is to his benefit. Because yet again, go ahead and limit. What he can, if he limits what he can do on the streams for his quote-unquote reaction show, then he can funnel people right to Patreon. So instead of you paying, I don't know, because there's what, three levels to his memberships, and with each level you gain more and more power. I don't know what his ultra tier is. Let's say it's 20 or 25 bucks or whatever the case may be. If you want a private video now, you got to pay double. You know what I'm saying? On Patreon. If you really want to see him do this, now you're going to have to pay the price. So either which way, it works out. But yet again, he's still a sniveling, disgusting little fucking pig. So we still got to try to go ahead and get our snout into the fucking mud and see if we can get that little bit extra. And that's why he's trying to maneuver people away from recommending anything that wouldn't allow him to monetize the actual video itself. Wow. Even though he's going to make the bulk of his money on everything else anyway.
Alright, another thing that we learn is that there's a certain kind of video that's very popular on YouTube, by the way. It's I would call it the infomentary, because it's not necessarily a documentary, but it's meant to be a short, concise video with a lot of information coming at you, where you can absorb a lot of things about a topic in a short period of time. For example, I've seen videos that talk about drilling into the earth, and what's the furthest anyone ever drilled into the earth, and what did they found down there, and the video's like 5 minutes long. It's very informative. Yesterday, someone nominated Did You Know Gaming's Street Fighter video from like 7-8 years ago. And in this, basically, it's all these factoids about classic Street Fighter. Okay?
Now, here's the thing. So, this guy, is he just now discovering top 10 lists or like, you know, top 50 or top 100 facts about a particular subject? He's made his living on YouTube begging for this long and he's just now discovering shit like this? I mean, what was that guy's name? The dude with the big teeth who, it's not funny, but he got abused by his girlfriend and shit, and no one believed him at first, and they called him a pussy because he was getting beat up. And then he ended up becoming the face for, like, male abuse, and I don't know if he was actually set out to do that, but that's what ended up happening. That and that chick was unfunny anyway. Listening to her jokes was abuse enough as far as I was concerned. Jesus Christ, she did not exactly help women in comedy with what she was pulling. It was Matthew something. It was Matthew Santorin, maybe? maybe, I don't know. He was a pretty funny guy. He had big teeth. And he got hit with plagiarism because he was pulling. I'm sorry, it's not funny. He got hit with plagiarism because he was taking his lists off of a website. I think it was like top 10 lists or list top 10. They're both sites that used to exist. I'm not sure if they exist anymore. And he was actually just pulling his content off of that, and he just wouldn't. He just wasn't sourcing them in the comment section, which really hurt his credibility for a long, long time. But his videos are still out and available. Shit, someone should recommend Phil to go over that shit. But, he's just now discovering that genre? That's wild. Holy shit. He really has wasted his life, hasn't he? Like, even basic shit like that. That's still a thing. That shit's been around for a really, really long time. Especially as it pertains to if he wants to just focus on video games or on wrestling in general. Matter of fact, I'm watching, I can't think of the channel for the life of me, but it's like this guy is going over like the real scumbags of wrestling right now. It's like three different wrestlers per episode, and you know, all kinds of just depravity, absolute fucking bullshit. Anywho, that's a good video that you should probably react to as well. To be honest with you, you'd be surprised some of the nonsense that goes on behind the scenes in wrestling that people just get away with, and even if they don't, the amount of chances that's been given to them is kind of silly. But anyway, sorry. But the point being is that this really goes to show how closed off he is. Like, this idiot is sitting here treating this shit like it's brand new. Like, he's walking into a fucking toy store or candy store for the very first time. In actuality, that candy store has been around for like 20 years. The candy store has been around for like 20 fucking years, and he couldn't get his head out of his own ass to kind of realize what was what. Wow. I guess ignorance is bliss, or at least so they say.
That's great. That's well and good, and it's informative. It's just not very good for reacting. Like, what am I to sit there? Oh, yeah, I didn't know that. Oh, that's right, I knew that. Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, that's right, I knew that. There's not much to react to there. There's not much to add, and it's not like you're having a funny reaction. It's just, oh, yeah, I get it. You understand? You see? They're perfectly valid videos. That's why they're popular on YouTube. They just don't work well for React style content, you see? And we learned that yesterday, because there was like two or three of them that were submitted, and everyone we watched were like, meh. Animal videos can be hit or miss. I would say, if you keep animal videos down to short videos, then it works. Or, if you watch a bit and then you move on. So for example, we started off yesterday's DSP versus the Internet with animals reunited with their owners. And it worked for like maybe 3-4 minutes, and then it got old. But it was good for the start. It was like a heartwarming way to start the stream, and it was very entertaining at first. There were funny animal videos. The funny stuff seems to always work. And then there was one where it was a first person. I guess what they did, they put a GoPro camera on a cat, and the cat was running around outside. I was fascinated. I was riveted. I was like, wow, life from the perspective of a cat. This is neat. You see the cat.
Really? I gotta ask you a question, Phil, because, you know, Jasper's declawed, and he can't go into your backyard or anything because there's squirrels, chipmunks, frogs out there, and it's on site, apparently, for Jasper if he goes outside, because he don't have no front claws and can't defend himself, allegedly. So, like, I mean, you ever thought about putting a GoPro on Jasper and have him running around the house or whatever, and see what, you know, and then put that online and see what that has to offer? I mean, I'm not trying to propose anything nefarious or anything, right? I'm not trying to say that, you know, anything, you know, would come out of that or whatever. I mean, you would have to put the raw footage up, Phil, because you can't edit anything. So, but you ever thought about doing that? That's an interesting concept, right? That'd be cool, right, Phil? You know? Have Jasper maybe go around the house a little bit with a GoPro on, see what the life of DSP's son is like. You know? Or even just have him go outside in the backyard. Just have him go out in the backyard. And maybe you or Catherine can supervise him. I mean, Catherine definitely needs the exercise, so it's not like it's, you know, it's a multi-type situation. No? Okay. I was just throwing it out there. You apparently need a lot of help, so.
Around the cats, you know, rolling around, relaxing, eating grass, chasing. It was fun. I really liked that. So that stuff all worked, I would say. Although you have to, I basically have to figure out how to make it digestible. You can't just sit there watching an animal video for 25 minutes. People will get bored.
Actually, you know what's fucked up? Theoretically, Jasper is getting cut. Because Jasper has no front claws, this is DSP's explanation, not mine. But because Jasper has no claws, he can't go outside because he's not safe. So DSP would rather watch another man or woman's cat go outside and do different shit instead of putting the effort into his own pet to do so. That's fucked up. So Catherine's cucking DSP by watching other men play video games. And Jasper's cucking, and Phil's cucking Jasper by watching other pets having actual normal lives while he's stuck in the fucking snort fort, slowly dying of urinary tract infection and whatever else. That's the Brunel household, ladies and gentlemen, if you really think about it. That's fucked up. That's fucked up. And then, if you really think about it, this is me being an asshole. Sorry, but not sorry. Theoretically, Catherine's getting cut too, because if she goes back and looks at all of the old footage of DSP when he was a bachelor, quote unquote, and then all of the years that DSP was with Panda, it's up to you and what your interpretation is on whether that was a better time or whatever. She sees all the opportunities that she's looking at, all the different situations and opportunities that she'll never have. That's fucked up. Remember all those trips that DSP used to take Panda on? And all the quote-unquote fun they used to have and all that bullshit? And Catherine gets none of that. And then, you know how DSP used to jerk off to all those figurines and shit in his condo and whatever? And Catherine's definitely not getting any of that. Panda didn't really get much of it either, so there's that too. That's fucked up, if you think about it. That sucks. It's amusing, but that sucks.
The fail and meme compilations seem to work, but again, they only work for a certain period of time. Sometimes people would submit like a 25-minute video and maybe playing it for like 5 to 10 minutes, and then you got to move on. You can't just have that going constantly. Again, that's the thing. I think that's the key with these shows. DSP versus the Internet is going to be keeping it moving, keeping it fresh, keeping it moving, not too much of the same thing, and then it gets stale or boring because you're just doing the same thing for an extended period of time. You see?
But that falls on you. That doesn't fall on them. If they recommend a video that's like 20 minutes or whatever and it's a fail compilation, that's up to you to judge how much time you want to devote to it or not. He essentially is telling people, hey, instead of you recommending a 25-minute video, pick a video that has 10 million, 20 million, 30 million views and it's only like 3 minutes long. So he wants them, even at that point, even at that level, to find him shorter and shorter videos so he can do less. All he has to do, start the video, give his fake goat laugh, and then move on. Instead of him actually doing some work. And his work isn't even a lot. Just watch like 3 or 4 minutes of it and then cut it off and move to the next one. Wow. Or even skip around the video a little bit if you feel the need to. Jesus Christ. Just finding more and more ways to be lazier and lazier about everything.
Some people are making some interesting suggestions. How about a try not to laugh compilation? Or how about viral videos from last week? All that would work. I think that stuff would work. Maybe once a week on DSP versus the Internet, a try not to laugh challenge segment. Where I try to watch something and see how long I can make it without laughing at it. Right? There you go. So we watched a lot. There was one of the things that I thought was one of the best things was a channel that I guess was a cooking video, but it was a really bad cooking video. And so I was trying to figure out, is this legit or not? Or is this someone actually acting? But I think maybe a cooking video every episode, like every week could work. And maybe it could be from different people across the internet who do cooking, some good, some bad. I would like to react to that. I think that would be good. And also, there was this really cool music remix from a flea market. Funny enough, that flea market rap, which I thought was the clip of the week, like I thought legit that was the best thing of the week, that damn thing got claimed. Yeah, the flea market song, someone must have bought it for its memeability, and that shit gets claimed on YouTube and they make ad revenue on the videos that anyone watches that. Can you believe that shit? I mean... That ad was obviously from like the 1990s or early 2000s. That place probably doesn't exist anymore. But the music is owned and actually claimed and money is made on it. I just, sure. Sure, if you say so. So anyway, what we
found, what's even funnier about that is he's mad that he can't exploit and profit off of something because someone else has already beaten him to it. That's literally the only reason why he's mad about that. That's hilarious. Secondly, why don't you pick 10 different topics, right? And, you know, and then what, you're doing 4 of those things a month, give or take. So then split those 10 different topics up week by week. You know what I'm saying? 3 here or 2 here, 3 here, whatever, whatever. And work it like that. So each week you essentially have something different. Why isn't he even thinking about doing that? Because there's a lot of topics out there. And he can give everybody a little bit of everything. Instead of just trying to give them everything. And then it all faltering because it becomes too much. Oh well. That might require a little too much common sense, I suppose.
Yesterday was that basically this variety style works. But you need to figure out the formula to make it digestible and fun. And keep it moving and make it feel fresh. So if you are a member on DSP Reacts. If you were there yesterday, you kind of saw what I mean. If you weren't there yesterday, watch these videos as they release over the week. 2 are already live yesterday. 1 just went live about an hour and a half ago. And then, like I said, 1 on Sunday, 1 on Monday, 1 on Tuesday. 6 videos total. Give them a look. You'll see what worked. You'll see what didn't. All right? You know what didn't work? Which I thought would work, and it didn't. So there are channels out there on YouTube. And what they do is they'll take, let's say, for example, a certain game series. Like a first-person shooter. Or Dark Souls, or a fantasy RPG like Skyrim. And they'll do a video that's supposed to be like, imagine if that were real, and so it's real people acting out the roles. And so, for example, I watched one yesterday, and it was real-life first-person shooter campaign starts up. So you zone in, and immediately you got some NPC in your face yelling at you orders, and you try to, the joke is, oh, if you try to talk to him further and ask him questions, he'll just ignore you. Then there's an NPC over there that's at the same line 14 times in a row and won't stop. So it's kind of like, oh, okay, that's funny for like 10 seconds. And then once you realize what the video is, it's no longer funny. It's kind of like this thing. There's this thing on the internet that I've noticed. It's kind of a group meme recognition, a feeling of like belonging.
Now keep in mind, this guy's supposed to be a real gamer, right? That's the situation. And you're being, like, he's supposed to be a real gamer. So something like that should be something that he could understand and relate to. And that's what it really comes down to. What makes it funny, what makes it entertaining, is the relatability. He don't see that because he's not a real gamer. He doesn't even like gaming. He only did it for profit. It was a means to an end. And he's only further exposing himself by that. Or with that, I should say. With his lack of interest to it. You know what I'm saying? Like, not everything needs to have some super deep meta. It just needs to be relatable. But if you believe that you're above everything, right? Or if you believe that you can suss out, you know, weak comedy compared to meaningful comedy, right? Then you're just going to miss the point altogether. And that's what this is. He's so desperate for validation, right? That he misses the simplicity. That is essentially entertainment or even comedy. He misses the simplicity of it. And it's because he never had it. And one of the reasons why he still doesn't have it is because he's a joke himself. And he hates it. But he can't do anything to change it. You know what I'm saying? So he has to look for validation on, oh, well, why do people think this is funny? I don't think it's funny. So what makes them think it's funny? And it makes them look... It really makes him come off, honestly, like a weirdo. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's really what it comes down to. And not in the type of way where it's like, I'm on Earth, but I'm not like you motherfuckers. No, it just really makes you come across like a fucking weirdo. You can't relate to any of this, right? Because you're just not built the same. You don't have... You're lacking something socially, if not even further, that actually makes these things relatable. That's what it is. Now, granted, you know, comedy and entertainment is subjective to a degree. You know what I'm saying? But you would think for the person who runs around crying and complaining about how he's a real gamer and he has something to say as it pertains to gaming and he should be taken seriously, when it's time to kind of dress down and actually just enjoy things for what they are, he completely gets mind fucked. For whatever reason, he's confused about these type of things. And that's why he'll never get anywhere. That's why he's essentially, well, he's probably worse than Carlos Mencia, to be honest with you. But that's the reason why he had to steal from everything and everybody in his early days to get to where he's at now. And now that he's on his own, now that he's stuck, now that he has to try to make his way on his own, he's lost. Have you ever thought about that? Early in his career, quote unquote, he could bounce off other people. He was stealing other people's bits. He was stealing other people's footage. He was doing whatever he could, you know what I'm saying, to get himself noticed and shit. But when you strip away all of the help, when you strip away all of the people that he can take advantage of, right? Or he could abuse or whatever the case may be. And you just and you're left with this husk of a person. You come to the realization there's nothing to him. You realize that there's nothing to him at all. And that's why he's so desperate to cling on to other people's ideas and make it work. But because he's an asshole, he needs to regulate that too. Oh, well, yeah, I need you guys' help to help me choose this or choose that and choose this. And then he has to sit there and shit on it when he's reacting to it and be like, well, I don't know why you guys actually chose this. What meaning does this really have? You know, how is this funny? How is this going to, what message does this have? And he's lost the point. He's lost the message. There was never a translation. He just never got the message.
Acceptance. So, for example, right now, if I said, never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and hurt you, I'm never gonna make you cry, I'm never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and desert you. Now, was that entertaining? No. But you know what that was? That was a meme. That was the Rick Roll meme. Everyone knows that meme because it was insanely huge a decade ago, correct? Correct. So, based on that meme, oh, group thing, oh, I know what that meme is. And immediately you almost get this feeling of acceptance because you know what it is. Right? You know the Rick Roll
meme. It's not someone knowing the meme. It's some the people understand what the reference of that meme is. That's what that comes down to. The song itself isn't a meme. Someone took parts of that music video and presented it as a meme, which in turn made people go off and find out what that really was. People recognize the song because of the meme. But the song is still something. It's still something that exists in itself. And truth be told, a lot of things like that is brought back into quote-unquote relevance, even if it's for the shortest amount of time, because somebody found the comedy or the humor in something. That's what it comes down to. You're overthinking this. And why are you even talking about memes anyway? Going back to that whole situation with Etika. Remember? When you sat there and you had your little pre-stream and it had like 15 fucking ad rolls in that bitch and you cried and complained about how memes are hurtful and look at what happened here and we need to grow up and understand that what we do on the internet has consequences or whatever the case may be. I'm just saying what you're saying or what you had said. You know what I'm saying? If memes are so fucking troublesome to you, then why are you engaging with it? And really, all you did was, to be honest, turn Etika's death into... You made Etika's death about you. You essentially said he was weak and that's why he's dead and I'm alive and I'm enduring all this, but people should stop because what happened to him could happen to anybody else. That's a really fucked up way of going about it, Phil. Because maybe, just maybe, whatever he was going through was bigger than whatever fucking meme that was being said about him online. You never thought about that though, right? You know, he was just another Negro that you could just go ahead and profit off of his death and then try to get yourself over on some other nonsense, right? It's not like the dead can't be useful, right, Phil? You know all about that. Like that situation with Kobe and that lost game file and how somehow they were equivalent. You losing a game file was equivalent to a man losing his life, as well as his daughter, as well as the other four or five people that were on that helicopter. You remember that, right, Phil? Pepperidge Farm remembers that.
Thoughts funny. And then they realized, well, it's not funny anymore. It's old. But you still had that moment of recognition. And when that moment of recognition hit, okay. I think that's how these videos get popular on YouTube. There's these recognition moments. Oh, I recognize that from that style of game. I recognize this from that style of game. And that's fine. But after about 2 seconds, you realize it's not very entertaining. You get those moments of recognition. Okay. And then, meh, who cares? Like, there was real life Dark Souls. Guy runs up, gets killed, drops his souls. He's frustrated because he dropped his souls. He runs up, gets killed, drops his souls, gets frustrated, runs up. And it's just the same thing for like 5 minutes. It doesn't even end. It's like, this isn't even good. This is stupid.
Well, I mean, being that you're a living piece of failure yourself, and there are compilations of you getting fucked over in Dark Souls and in first-person shooters and everything else, I could see why you don't see the fun in it. And that's really what it comes down to, ladies and gentlemen. Excuse me. His disdain or his lack of interest as it pertains to some of these things, right, really comes down to his personal experiences. How he's been laughed at, how he's been mocked, and whatever the case may be. A lot of this shit hits too close to home. That's really what some of this comes down to. Because it's funny how the toilet humor, the shit being inserted in his ass, and all that other stuff is funny, right? You know what I'm saying? People falling on their face, especially kids. I don't know why he has a good time looking at that shit. But kids bumping over and like, you know, landing face first and shit like that. You know, all of that inspires many, many, many goat laughs. But when it comes down to something that actually... when it comes down to something that actually reflects back to him a failure that he has demonstrated and that other people have latched onto and made memes out of and whatever, made stuff, you know, as he said, easily recognizable. Oh, that's just not interesting no more. That's just not really that funny. I don't really see or understand the value in that. I don't know what the problem is. Why can't you guys be grown up about it? I don't know. I just don't. I feel like that's just a waste of time. Take a lot of that into consideration. That's really what it is. He's essentially making an enemy, right, out of content that he's supposed to be pretending to laugh it up to. Because let's be honest, most of the laughing that he does is fake anyway to some of those reactions. It is what it is. It definitely comes across insincere. You know what I'm saying? He can't let himself just let go for a small period of time. You're being paid for this. You're being paid for this. You're paid on the front end, plus you're going to make some money off of the stream. Things don't need to be complicated. Things don't need to have a meaning. You know what I'm saying? Just let entertainment be entertainment. Oh well.
Right? So again, there's some things that look like you think on paper that would work. But when you start to watch it and react to it, you're like, it's boring. I never understood those groupthink things anyway. Like, memes, I can get how a meme can be funny and can add to something. At the same time, I think that too many people put too much mindless following and recognition into memes. That's why you get channels like that are popular. But really, if you look at the substance of the channel, there's nothing there. It's all fluff, you know? So anyway, that was another style of video we watched. It did not work, okay? It just wasn't entertaining. So anyway, here's what I think is going to happen. So now, we have a whole week.
Now, here's the irony of that. It's all fluff. There's no meaning behind it. It has no real value. He supposedly, you know, his content supposedly has all this value, has all this meaning, and that's why, you know, the 200, 300, 400 people still care about him and contribute in such a way so he can still make a living. Yet the internet as a whole don't give a fuck unless there's a detractor, troll, hater, or critic either going over and re-editing it or mocking it in a commentary type way. Why can't any of his actual content on its own do well by itself? Why does someone else have to swoop in and add something to it? Charm, charisma, some real insight to actually make it palatable, to make it acceptable, to make it entertaining. Something to think about.
The next episode of DSP versus the Internet, correct? It's next Friday is when we're doing it, just for the record. Now, what's going to happen is the members are now going to reconvene, I bet. They're going to redouble their efforts. Already some have. I think we already have like a dozen postings for next week's show. And I think what will happen is as they watch the show, they'll say, okay, this worked and this didn't. We're getting some bit different and better ideas. and they're going to submit some different and better videos. And what's going to end up happening is maybe over a month, maybe a little longer, right? What's going to happen is we're going to get this down to a science. We're going to get videos from the internet every week that are entertaining and fun to watch. It's going to be, you know, just from the get-go, every video is going to be hit, and then a miss every once in a while, but mostly hits. And once we get it down to that rhythm, the show's going to be much better. But that's the thing with a show like this. I've never done a React channel before. This is all growth and how it works, okay? Now, what I would also say is if
actually, the same type of mindset is what killed the Vest streak, for any of you guys who remember that. The same type of mindset, the same type of consistent, guaranteed, you know what I'm saying, type mindset, right? Where, you know, it had this has worked before, so it needs to continue to keep working. This type of mindset is what killed the Vest streak. That's why this channel is doomed to fail. Doomed to fail. And you're already, he's kind of laying out what the criteria are. 1, ad revenue. 2, ad revenue. 3, ad revenue. 4, it needs to be entertaining to me. It has to be absolutely, positively entertaining to me. It has to be something that I can't mock. I can't tear down. I can't see the... It has to be something so blatantly funny, right? That I can't... That there's no pushback from me whatsoever. If for even a solitary second he feels like, oh, well, I think this is kind of mindless, or this is kind of stupid, or I don't get the joke, or whatever the case may be. Whoever it was who donated, or not donated, but who recommended it, you failed. You failed miserably. So now, if you want me to go over more content like that, you're going to have to go to my Patreon, because that's the only way I'm going to do it from here on out. See how he's slowly but surely, essentially, choking this thing in its crib. Even though it's, you know, well into its maturity, to be honest with you. But you get my drift. You know, you're taking a new thing, and instead of going through the growing pains, he wants to be able to profit off of it almost immediately. And because of that is one of the reasons why it's destined to fail. And then everybody's going to mock him. Everybody's going to laugh at him. And it's just another thing he's going to have to live with. And then he's going to do is just cry to his audience. Well, first he's going to blame his audience for his failure. Because we're used to that at that point, right? We've all seen that. And then he'll blame the detractors, trolls, haters, and critics, saying that they mocked him and they made light of it. And you know, it was a fun little thing and they figured out a way to ruin everything. Or they kept saying it was going to fail, so it eventually did. You know, pathetic little things like that. The downfall of this shit's going to be fantastic. But like I said, it's really going to come down to how long is he willing to keep this up? How long will his frail little ego keep this dumb shit up? But even probably more important than that, how long will people let him exercise the type of control to where it's so accommodating to him and it becomes less and less entertaining for them? That's the real question. Are these people really willing to continue to throw their money and give up on the actual entertainment value that they're paying for so he can keep his frail little ego intact? Because sooner or later, he's going to turn this reaction channel bullshit into it's us versus the detractors. And if you guys have to keep contributing so I can keep this going, so I can prove to them that this channel is not the failure that they say it is. Eventually, that's what it's going to turn into. And especially if he can get people to commit just on the strength of that channel getting that 100,000 YouTube button, then he'll push that narrative. I guarantee it. It's going to be a slow burn. A slow burn. Should still be fun, though.
Watched that show yesterday live, or if you're watching it slowly on demand over the week, and you think you could do better, I challenge you to do better. Because it was funny, there were people sitting there on the show, oh, this is boring. Okay, you do better then. You nominate better videos, right? Why not? If you're so involved and you're so...
Nominating better videos doesn't help if you don't get it. He's not even really willing to sit down and let a video breathe. It's just like you opening a really good bottle of wine. You don't just pop open the bottle of wine and start pouring and drinking. You let the bottle breathe. I mean, he don't know that, but whatever. It is what it is. But you know what I'm saying? It's like that. But if you don't, if you're not willing to let the give the content a real chance, then it doesn't matter what anybody recommends. And that's really what it comes down to. This dude's a fucking alien. Dude's a fucking weirdo. He's so I want to say despondent, but he's so resistant, or he's so, say despondent. He's so despondent to the content before he actually watches the damn thing that it doesn't even matter what they recommend. It really don't. It won't matter. The guy doesn't have any personality to him. He doesn't have any charisma. So he's not willing to give something a chance. He automatically assumes the worst and expects the best. How do you... You can't bring a clean thing out of an unclean thing. That's not. That's just not how that's going to work. At least not for him.
And you want to see this get better. You're saying, oh, this isn't very good, right? Then become a member and nominate videos. You know what really worked? And I've never seen Video Game Donkey before. His video was legitimately good. I laughed a bunch during that video. I thought the delivery was good, and I thought it was smart the way he did it. I thought it was a fun video. And the only thing I'd ever heard about that guy before was that he did a bad review of Sonic Frontiers, and everyone was crapping on him and said, wow, you're irresponsible. But the video that he made that we watched was...
That's interesting, because you would think for all the good that that guy has done, and all the praise that he gets on the internet, especially on Twitter, it's funny how the one thing that DSP has ever heard from him was a negative. The King of Hate's really living up to that moniker, isn't it?
So that's the kind of thing, maybe, to open my eyes to other content creators that I've never seen before, maybe a great way to get this show better every week.
Actually, let me point out another hypocrisy in all this bullshit. So, as long as that dude's been around, and all the the majority of praise that this guy gets, DSP only heard of him because of one bad, quote-unquote, bad take that the guy had, right? Did he go to his channel and actually watch the content and see if that criticism was valid? No. But when DSP gets shitted on, if someone took 5 minutes of research and actually checked out my content, they would see I'm not as bad as they say. But was he willing to do it for this guy here? Was he willing to give this guy the benefit of the doubt? Something to think about.
Content from other content creators, and let me see their work for the first time, and I could judge for myself if I like it or not. Like, for example, Video Game Donkey, that was good. That maybe could be the kind of channel that I would watch, right? XQC, I think I would rather stick my head in the toilet and flush a few times, because I can't even understand what he's saying half the time. The guy goes on his insane rant. You can't understand what the hell he's talking about. His voice, is like, what is happening? The best moment of the XQC video was when he was playing the game where it was underage Japanese anime girls, and there's a vacuum sucking at their crotches, and his face goes like this. Like, he's delighted. He's ultimately delighted at what he's seeing, like, okay, and this guy's still on the internet. 50,000 viewers a stream, huh? Anyway, so, there you go. I think that in summary...
I don't know. You and XQC have a lot in common. I mean, recently, he was streaming, and he showed his room, and he's got, like, this nice little trash pile on one side of his desk and on the fucking floor. He admits that it smells... And how that's just, like, under his feet and everything, but won't do anything to clean that shit up. On top of that, XQC has quite the history of being a resentful piece of shit. Like you, Phil. Honestly, you and XQC have a lot in common, except for he's successful, and he has money and shit. But both of you guys got autism and whatever else. So, there's that. So there is a connection there between the two of y'all in some ways, shape, or form. But whatever. Whatever. There's a level of camaraderie between the two of you. That's for damn sure. That's for damn sure. XQC hates it when other people get credibility or get praise for something. He hates it to the very bowels of his own soul for whatever reason, which is interesting too. It just goes to show. It really does. It just goes to show, despite the money that you make or despite the success that you've had, you can still be a resentful piece of garbage to someone else. It's fascinating. This is someone who's been so resentful that he's fucked over his own friends in tournaments just because over a momentary lapse of judgment, he sat there and damn near fucked over friendships. And he didn't, and for that brief period of time, he didn't care. He was angry and he wanted to do what he wanted. Sounds familiar, right? Right? Right.
Okay, it will. It'll get better in time. I'm sure people are going to submit more and different things for this. And I can't wait to watch more next week. Whatever you guys want. Again, whatever the members nominate. If you're someone who thinks you can do better, I challenge you to do better. Right? Become a member, nominate, and beat what those people did.
He's literally trying to turn, within his own community, he's turning this into an us versus them. Oh, you think the content that this person or these people have already recommended was bad? Okay, well, you step the fuck up and beat them. Prove them that they need to step their shit up and they need to be better and do better. But what is he doing? Think about that for a minute. He's literally trying to have two groups of people turn against each other, while at the end of the day, he's going to end up shitting on all of them anyway, plus he reaps all the benefits. And the crazy part is, there's a small group of dents out there who's actually going to fall for this shit. That's the crazy part. Anywhere else, people would have seen this for what it was.
I bet that you guys could maybe top what they did. All right? But, you know, there's no point in sitting around and saying, oh, well, that sucked. Okay, so do better. That's the point of DSP Reacts, is that you get the opportunity now to actually put those videos in my line of sight. The videos that you think are the best.
And he's struggling. This struggle session is fantastic at this point because he's struggling. No, I'm going to bring us back just a little bit. Right before his piggy hooves cross. He's struggling not to shit on the people who have already given him money to try to motivate these other people to give him money. He is struggling hard because you know he just wants to go ahead and bash the previous people. Despite the fact that DSP got his money, he looks at it as, oh, well, you guys embarrassed me out there. So now I got to challenge a whole new group of people to come in and fix your asshole's mistakes. But then there's a part of him being like, wait a second. Dumbass, don't shit on the people that are giving you money right now. If you do that, you may not get anything out of the people you're trying to challenge, and then you'll lose money from the dumbasses that have already given you money. He's literally having an inner conflict about this. This shit's funny. This shit is funny.
Bet that you guys could maybe top what they did. All right? But, you know, there's no point in sitting around and saying, oh, well, that sucked. Okay, so do better. That's the point of DSP Reacts, is that you get the opportunity now to actually put those videos in my line of sight. The videos that you think are the best for me to react to, put them in my line of sight. Do it. I want the best videos possible, but I need people to do that. I don't know. I can't be everywhere at all times. I'm already working 6 days a week full time doing gameplay and shit. I don't know what else is on the internet. That's the whole point of this project, right?
Despite the fact that that's this idiot's job. And theoretically, his quote-unquote bottom bitch, pre-bitch podcast, right there is supposed to be an example of that. You're on Twitter all fucking day, looking for all this negativity and shit, and you can't figure out what any of the trends are because of Twitter, or off of Twitter that can help you with YouTube. He literally told you, I can't do anything. I'm not smart enough. You please do it. And then, it's like this really fucked up gouty Ponzi scheme. The people who come in on the ground floor, he loves you, or he doesn't love you. He doesn't give a fuck about you. Let me just keep that. Let's be frank about that. But, oh, he appreciates your support. He loves you. The fact that you love him, yada, yada, yada. You lay down the foundation. Your bodies, your bones, lay out the fucking foundation. It's in the fucking mortar. But then the group of people that come next, oh, well, they're the ones that he really cares about. Those guys at the bottom, they just laid down the foundation is what it is. You guys are the real heroes. You guys are the ones who really come through, who support me, and are really helping me out right now. I very much appreciate it. And then he builds on top of them. And then he builds on top of them. And so all he's essentially doing is trying to get people to top each other, so to keep his ass at the very top of the fucking pyramid. And then when the pyramid falls, and he already has their money, then he can sit there and shit on all of them as a collective. Each one of you guys fucking failed me. At every layer, at every level of this, you guys fucked up. I gave you guys all the power. I gave you guys... I listened to all of your guys' criticisms. I listened to all of your suggestions, and it still failed. And whose fault is that? And the crazy part is, at least 70% of those dumbasses are going to believe it. They're going to believe that they were the ones that were actually responsible. They're going to believe that they're the ones who actually failed. He tried to pull the exact same shit with the Vestry. He damn near did the exact same thing for the Vestry, and you saw how that happened. When the Vestry started, for better or worse, there were actually a rotation of people who really, you know, contributed a little bit to help reach that shit. As he became more demanding, less and less people did it, and less people end up taking up the charge or the responsibility to actually hit the goal. To the point where it was literally down to like three people. At the very end, it was only down to two. And that was only Ice Coffee and Swaggins. And it made sense that one of them or both of them let that shit go. Because it was not going anywhere. It was totally reliant on them to keep that shit going day by day. It was retarded. It really was. What was it? $200 a day? So what, $1,700 between the... But a week? Between the two of them, damn near? Fuck all that.
Okay. Okay. So, go for it. Let's see what happens next week. Hopefully next week, it's even better. Every week, hopefully we get better. All right? Now, I will say this.
Actually, it was 12. Sorry, it was $1,200 because he doesn't work 7 days a week. But you get my drift.
The major focus and the major way I'm going to make any kind of profits on DSP Reacts is memberships. Okay? That's true. Because most of those videos I put on that channel will get demonetized. So, again, if you like that content, please become a member. And please nominate videos. You don't have to. You could easily become a member and never nominate anything. And that's okay. But the memberships over there are going to be the key to the success of that channel. As opposed to on DSP Gaming, this is a mix of everything. We got some ad revenue coming in. You guys support me on the streams or whatever. But on DSP Reacts, it's primarily going to be those memberships. So please, if you can, please become a member today. All right? All right. Very nice. How many members? I think we're in the 40s. Suck a surprise. We're like low 40, probably like 42 members, something like that. And like I said, it would be great to get some more. Like if every week I could gain like 5 members over there, I'd be happy with that. Seriously. It'd be slow growth. But, you know, and Cracker Jack says tips were strong. That is true, but here's the thing, Cracker Jack. You can't expect that.
Gaining five new subs or whatever, or memberships, I should say, a week over there means jack shit if you can't keep the ones that you've already made. And that's what it really comes down to. That's why gifted subs, or gifted memberships, I'm sorry, is like, it's going to be, if it's not his go-to yet, and it kind of is, you know what I mean. If it's not his go-to yet as it pertains to that channel, it will be. And yet again, he's just putting himself in a situation where he's going to further box himself in. And he don't even see it. The same retardation that he's been doing on DSP Gaming that he has failed at and that people keep mocking him over, he's going to go ahead and try the same thing on a whole nother channel, expecting the exact same fucking result. That's insane. Literally the definition of insanity.
You can't. What I make on a live stream fluctuates like this, correct? What I make on a live stream is always, if you have a good stream where someone shows up and they're feeling generous, wow. Then you get a stream that's a great stream, but, you know, no one's contributing that day and there's nothing you can do about that. You know what I'm saying? It goes like this. But members, that's key consistent income. And if I'm going to be putting out a lot of work on that channel, which right now I am, it would be great to have the consistency rather than, oh, I do one stream a week and the stream makes some money, you know. It's better to have the consistency of members, you see. Okay.
But in truth, he wants all of it. So, the memberships, the tipping, super chats, or, well, super thanks, I should say. I mean, super chats are part of the tipping, really. He wants it all. And it's not gonna work out. It's for DSP Reacts to be successful, DSP Gaming is gonna have to fall a bit. I'm not sure if it's going to fall by the wayside, but it's going to fall. Like, it's going to be very... I'd be very shocked to see him hit 600 subs on DSP Gaming and then hit 400 or 500 subs on DSP Reacts. I'll be shocked to see that happen. And if it does happen, I can almost guarantee this. You're going to see him sneak this both audiences saying, well, how is it that we were able to get this much here and this one over here, but you guys could never get 1,000 or hold 1,000 on DSP Gaming? I guarantee you that's going to come up. I almost guarantee it. Because as resentful as he is, it's something that he's going to hold on to. You know, I had all these different types of membership goals set up and we couldn't hit them, and I had to reduce the membership goal, yada, yada, yada. But I do this new thing over here. I'm putting in all this work, and you guys can, you know, be supportive, but you couldn't be supportive on DSP Gaming when I was offering you all this stuff. And then all the quote-unquote he says that he's putting in on DSP React. What happens when he can't keep that up? I mean, theoretically, he can't. He's already telling people to recommend him the funniest stuff possible in shorter durations, so he doesn't have to do any extra work. He doesn't have to skim through the video. He has his little 2-minute, supposedly hilarious video that he can go through, get his laughs, collect his money for it, and then keep moving. So he's already becoming lazier and lazier and lazier as literally the days or the weeks are going on with this channel. This channel's going to fail. This channel's going to fail hard. There's no way that someone's going to give him 300 or 400 gifted subs on DSP Gaming and then pop up another 400 or 500 on DSP React. It's just not going to happen. It's not. It really isn't. And he apparently is very invested in DSP React's working out. You can tell he has a lot of hope in the upcoming months that shit's going to be something. And it's not. He's setting himself up because he's already proving he's not willing to put in the work. He is so reliant on someone else, on another man or woman to do the work for him, that it's all going to crash and burn. And then he's just going to push even more people away, which is just going to be a whole lot more funnier for everybody else.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen, that's what's going on over there, and I hope that it sounds good to all of you, all right? I guess what I'd like to do next, I would like to talk about some news, all right? We have some news to cover, all right? Let's talk about it. I think 3 news stories today. Let's take a quick look.
Okay. I asked Dig to leave this in here, right? This is him talking about his quote-unquote viral tweet I don't even know what he tweeted about. It doesn't even really fucking matter. It's another example of needing validation from the internet that hates him so goddamn much. And he's yet again fighting on multiple fronts, thinking that if he can drum up some type of support on Twitter, that, you know, maybe people will give him a shot, give him a look, as if he's, you know, as if his presence on Twitter isn't as toxic as it is on YouTube or on Twitch. It's pathetic. It's funny to watch, but it's pathetic. And that's why I think he's glad that this pro Jarrett situation happened. I wouldn't be surprised if he actually brings up the tweets during that reaction fucking event or whatever, if it's actually happening. And he talk about, you know, hey, this is what happened with my tweets. This is what I said. This is those, I don't know, it's Christian values or fucking moral high grounding or whatever the fuck, right? I wouldn't be surprised if he brings that shit up because he was really proud of that shit. I mean, in a pathetic sort of way. It's the type of validation you see from like Keffels and people like that talking about racialing and shit. It's really sad because at the end of the day, it's just invisible numbers. It don't mean anything. Keffels isn't going to be able to fucking finesse another $100,000 off people. People already caught what the scheme is. They're never going to get away with something like that again. You know what I mean? So if DSP thinks he's going to get validation by ratioing whatever, you're wrong. You're wrong. The internet doesn't move like that anymore. And it's definitely not going to move like that for you. You know, that shit that Keffels pulled is like a one-shot type thing. You know, that's not going to happen for them again. It'll be the next person who tries to pull that bullshit, at least in the same sector, is going to be very hard-pressed to get away with it. People need to remember their footing.
News story number 1. Okay, news story number one. I ratioed Netflix. Who cares? It took over a week. Remember I told you last week about a viral tweet that I inadvertently made on my day off? I don't know why, but all week people kept liking my tweet, but then people kept going back and liking the Netflix tweet that it was in response to. Likely because people hate me so much, they didn't want to see me ratio Netflix. So they tried for a week and a half, and it, to no avail, I ratioed Netflix yesterday. So that's two big ratios for me. I ratioed the Academy Awards, or the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences last year.
You saw how he tried to make it seem bigger than what it was? He ratioed the Oscars. Period. But he had to go into the whole long-winded version of it to give himself more prestige. That's sad. That's really sad. Especially since nobody even remembers those tweets. And then the supposed ratioing of Netflix, he beat it by, what, six? Maybe seven, I guess? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like six or seven likes is what he beat it by. And it took it a week. It took it a week. He couldn't even replicate the fucking quote-unquote success he had from the Oscar tweet, which he did in a night. It took a week. And then what? And then DSP being a bitch, right? Because he has to explain his failure, right? This is supposedly a win for him, but he doesn't really care about it. But he has to explain why it failed, and it took so long for him to ratio it. Is, oh, my detractors, trolls, haters, and critics must have gone ahead and done that. He must have forgot. He must have forgot. You know what I'm saying? He could fuck around and find out if he want to. But detractors, trolls, haters, and critics have been putting work on him on Twitter for a really long time. If they cared, if they really cared, they'd have blown him out the water 4 or 5 days previous. They wouldn't have needed a week. No one cared. It didn't catch on because no one gave a fuck. Most people don't even know about the new change that Netflix is getting ready to do yet. Which all that is that you can't share accounts anymore. But it don't matter because people will figure out a way around it. Someone on Reddit, I'm sure, already has. So it don't even matter. It don't even matter. So you didn't ratio shit. You really didn't. And inadvertently on your day off, congratulations, you idiot, you played yourself. So you spend all day on Twitter. So you spend your days off on Kiwi Farms, on Twitter, watching detractor content, seeing what's being said about you. Oh no, it's like we didn't already know that. It's not like we didn't already know that he was drama hounding all over Twitter, looking for something negative to talk about on the pre-bitch podcast the next day, and looking for a tweet that he can, that would hope raise his profile overnight, so then when he shows up to the podcast or the pre, or whatever, to the bottom bitch podcast the next day, oh, maybe there'll be a few more people there. And if there's a few more people there, excuse me, maybe a few more of them will throw some money my way. Maybe he can get a bigger influencer to swing by and be like, yeah, Phil, you know what? You were right about this one. Here's $100. And I'm going to tell people to give you money too. We already saw that with Rich. You know what I'm saying? Rich is already a pay pig. And that didn't really help too much. I mean, people did, you know, come around and give you money. But after a while, he went ahead and told them not to do it. He may be still pay pigging for you. We don't know. But, you know, it didn't really help when Rich tried to pull that bullshit. So, still hoping for some type of validation on the internet. Yikes.
Slap tweet, and now I ratio Netflix for their dumb tweet trying to spin their disabling of password sharing as a positive feature. So there you go. Does it matter? No, it does not. It's not news. It's just something stupid that I wanted to mention. None of this means anything. I gained nothing from it. It's hilarious. People say, wow, Phil was really correct in this tweet. Good for him. Oh, by the way, I still hate his guts. He's the worst person on the planet. It's like, okay. Continuing on. All right. Continuing on.
That moment of reconciliation, of self-reflection at the end, was fantastic. And he tried to play it off by wiping the fucking bacon grease off his fucking face and shit on his dirty ass shirt and acted like it didn't hurt. That shit hurt. Ladies and gentlemen, right there, that little bit, that right there hurt. It's that same type of validation that you see from King Cobra when he makes a good point on the internet at one time or another, and he was hope that, you know, some people would give him ass pats for it or whatever the case may be, and he don't get it. It's just like that. And that's what makes a lol cow a lol cow. They do stupid shit, they get mocked for it, whatever the case may be, but when they finally do something, you know what I'm saying? They're waiting for the cheers, they're waiting for the pats on the shoulder or on the back that, hey, you did a good thing. And they damn sure know that it's not going to end up happening. It's not going to come. Heh. But they still have high hopes for it anyway. Take that for what that is. Because that's exactly what that is. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Give me a few minutes to kind of convey my thoughts or whatever. And we'll reconvene and, you know, that'll be a thing. Let's see here. Now, let's go ahead and end it the way we started. Here we go.
Oh yeah, I get around. Still clown when the underground. When we come around, stronger than ever. Back to get wrecked. All respect to those who break their neck to keep their hopes in check, cause though they sweat a brother majorly. And I don't know why your girl keeps paging me to tell me that she needs me. Cries when she leaves me, and every time she sees me, she squeeze me. Lady, take it easy. Hate to sound sleazy, but tease me. I don't want it if it's that easy. Hey yo, bust it. Baby, got a problem saying bye-bye. Just another
ass of a fly guy. I wonder how many times Kat has heard that one. Anywho. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so what do we make out of all this? excuse me. What do we make out of all this? It's interesting to watch DSP try to quote-unquote build something half-assed as usual, using already broken toys or broken assets, if you will, or even outdated assets in some way, shape, or form to try to make himself relevant. And still figure out a way to do it wrong. We're talking about YouTube, ladies and gentlemen. We're talking about a practice that have made. We're talking about a genre of videos that have made people rich. You know what I'm saying? Like, have made people well off. People have used that to springboard themselves to do other shit. And DSP popping up super late to the game as usual because he thought he was above it. He thought he was better than it. And now, he's doing it all wrong, essentially. And yet he convinced people to pay him up front to actually do the quote unquote work. That's the part that got me fucked over, that fucks me a little bit, is the fact that he was able to convince people to put money down towards membership so they can have the right to vote. Cause you got to understand, the casual person doesn't get anything out of this. You just get to watch whatever content comes out of this later. You don't have a say so and not a goddamn thing. Everybody else has to toss money in. And then, like I said, you have three different tiers, and the top two tiers are the ones who really get the vote. They're the ones who, well, everybody gets a vote, but their vote actually means something. That entry level tier, you get nothing. You know what I'm saying? He gives you the illusion that you have a choice. Or you have power. Realistically, you don't have a goddamn thing. If you're not on that, it's super, and then I think it's like the ultra tiers. If you're not on either one of those planes, you're not getting nothing. You're no different than the peon who isn't throwing no money in at it at all. He just makes you feel special that you've contributed to the larger situation. And the fact that people fell for that boggles the goddamn mind. But more importantly, ladies and gentlemen, when all this shit fails, as it will inevitably, everybody will be punished for it. Everybody will be ridiculed. Everybody will be mocked. Everybody will be held over the fire and shit, just as DSP will be held over the fucking fire when his bacon is being cooked. Nothing good ever comes out of helping this man, ever. And yet there's still a large demographic that feels the need to do it, to be compelled to do it. I thought this was supposed to be about entertainment, right? You come here to be entertained, right? Like, that's what you have to do. You're not obligated to provide anything. If you decide to donate, if you decide to give a little bit extra because you appreciate it, whatever the case may be, that's on you. You know, that's something that you've chosen to do, not something that you feel compelled to do. Somewhere down the line, that was forgotten. somewhere down the line, that was misconstrued, or that was misinterpreted, really. With, instead of being a gesture of gratification, to being an obligation, to being mandatory. Why? I don't know. But at the end of the day, if you're not investing in yourself, right? If you're not investing in yourself first, how can you really help anybody else? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening in. I very much appreciate it. I'll catch you for the next one, whenever that may be. Like I said, I have no clue what the order is for some of this stuff. So, you know, I leave that to other people or whatever the case may be. But hopefully some of this, yeah, I mean, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, for some of you guys, you catch it, you don't. It's no big deal. But hopefully it's somewhat concise. It doesn't have to necessarily be in order, but somewhat concise. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Snort Report, and this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking, unreliable coverage that you can't count on. It's GTG Network, GTG Network and Productions. I've been your host. Catch you on the flip. Later. Jiffy, don't be picky, just be happy with this quickie. But when you learn, you can't time it down, baby doll. Check it out, I get around. What you mean you don't know? Check it, I get around. The underground just don't stop for hoes. I get around, still down with the underground. I get around. Hey, yo, shot. Let them hoes know.
Now you can tell from my everyday fits, I ain't rich.